السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل وغوى. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. My dear brothers and sisters, the ayah, the verse that I recited, this is the ayah number 186 from Surah Al-Baqarah. So this great ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned among the verses related to the month of Ramadan, related to the fasting. Three verses before this ayah, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyam. So they all talk about the issues of fasting. And the next ayah, after this ayah, the long ayah, it also talk about fast, the issues of fasting, the issue of qiyam, the issue of i'tikaf. So all the ayahs around this ayah, they talk about the month of Ramadan, they talk about the fasting, the ahkam, and the issues of related to the fasting and the month of Ramadan. So the question is, what is the wisdom, what is the logic keeping and mentioning this ayah among the ayahs related to the fast and related to the month of Ramadan? So obviously Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wants us to know that the month of Ramadan is not only the month for fasting. It is not the month for qiyam, nor the month of i'tikaf, nor the month of other ibadah. It's also the month of dua. This is the month, this great month and the blessed month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our dua. He accepts the dua all the year, all the time. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانَ. I accept the dua whenever the person he calls on me, whenever he asks me, I accept the dua. All the time, whether it is Ramadan, out of Ramadan, whether it is that day or night, morning or evening, any time you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He accepts your dua. But the month of Ramadan is a special month when du'as are not rejected. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that لِكُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ دَعْوَةٌ مُسْتَجَابَةٌ يَدْعُو بِهَا فِي رَمَضَانِ. Every Muslim's dua which he makes in the month of Ramadan, دَعْوَةٌ مُسْتَجَابَةٌ, that dua is accepted. In the month of Ramadan, our du'as are accepted. As I mentioned in my last khutba, that this is the month when all doors of hellfire and Allah's ghadab are closed. All doors of Allah's mercy, Allah's rahmah, paradise, they are opened. So that is the why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He accepts all your du'as, especially at the time of iftar. This is the blessed time, my dear brother, that we normally waste in preparing dishes. That's the best time Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he used to sit down with his family member at that time and he used to make dua. Dua are not rejected at the time of iftar. Duas are accepted during the days and nights of the month of Ramadan. Because Allah Rabbul Alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his beautiful name is Al-Mujib. Allah is Al-Mujib. Allah Rabbul Alameen, he says that, وَنُوحًا إِذَ نَادَى مِنْ قَبْلٍ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ فَلَنِعْمَ الْمُجِيبُونَ فَلَنِعْمَ. We are the best who accept dua, who respond. Allah is Al-Mujib. Whenever you make dua, ud'uni astajib lakum. Make dua, I accept your dua, I respond to your call. So Allah Rabbul Alameen, whenever you make dua, my dear brother, Allah Rabbul Alameen accept your dua. This is the one of the greatest hope, encouragement and excitement for a believer. You can never think a Muslim, a mu'min, and he is a panic, he is a stressed. As nowadays, this is a big issue among the people, among modern society, that stressful society. There's a BBC report that every fourth woman in UK is suffering from stress. So how can you expect a Muslim and a mu'min or a muslima or a mu'mina who believes in Allah Rabbul Alameen, who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a beautiful name and attribute, that he accepts to our dua, he responds to our dua, and still he is stressful? Whatever the stress you are facing, whatever the problem you are facing, you must know that Allah Ahkamul Hakimin is Al-Mujib. He accepts my dua. Whatever the problem you are facing, ask Allah Ahkamul Hakimin. Surely he will remove that sorrow and suffering. Allah Ahkamul Hakimin has mentioned in Surah Al-Anbiya. This is a long surah. Allah Ahkamul Hakimin has mentioned so many prophets. And Allah mentioned, after mentioning their sorrows and suffering, Allah said that they made dua, they call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ, and we accepted his dua. وَنُوحًا إِذَ نَادَى مِنْ قَبْلٍ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. Nuh alayhi salam, he called on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ, and we accept his dua. وَأَيُّوَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ مِنْ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. أيوب عليه السلام, he was suffering from a disease for more than 16 or 17 years. He was not despair of Allah, Ahkamul Hakimin's mercy. He was not despair of Allah's mercy. He called on Allah, رَبِّي أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. We accepted his dua. Then Allah mentioned, Nuh, Yunus alayhi salam, can your sorrows and calamities be worse than those of Yunus alayhi salam? Imagine, there was only one incident in the whole history of mankind that a man was devoured by whale, and that whale went down in the depth of the oceans. Allah says that Yunus Islam is nada rabba fi zulumat, from the layers of darknesses, several layers of darkness. One darkness of that of night, the second is the ocean, and the third the stomach and the belly of the whale. And Allah says that when Yunus Islam wanada fi zulumat, Allah ilaha illa anta subhanak inni kuntu min al-zalimin fastajabna lahu. We accepted his dua. We responded to his dua. Allah protected him. Allah saved him. And he came out alive. Likewise, Allah said that Zakariya, that mentioned Zakariya alayhi salam, who was 100 years old. 100 years old. His wife was 100 years old. And she was aqib. She was barren, unable to produce, unable to give birth. At that time, is nada rabbahu nida'an khafiyya. He called on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala silently, whispering. Why? He was shy that if people, they hear his voice, if they hear, if they know about his dua, they made mock, they make fun of him because he was 100 years old, and 100 year old person, he's asking Allah for a baby. Allah said that is nada rabbahu nida'an khafiyya qala rabbi inni wahana al'azmu minni washta'ala ar-ra'su shayba wa lam akun bi du'a'ika rabbi shaqi. Allah said fastajabna la wa wahabna lahu yahya wa aslahna lahu zawna. We perfected his wife, we cured his wife, and we granted him Yahya. Allah himself named the baby Yahya, and this is a miracle that Allah showed in this dunya. All these incidents, my dear brother, to make us believe that whatever the problem you face in this dunya, whether domestic, whether your social, whether business, whether whatever, whether in your body, whether any kind of disease, never despair of Allah's mercy. Ask Allah. Keep asking, keep asking. Your dua never goes waste. Du'as are never rejected. Our beloved Prophet ﷺ is saying that. مَا مِن مُسْلِمٍ يَدْعُو بِدُعَاءٍ إِلَّا اسْتُجِيبَ لَهُ. Whenever a Muslim, he asks Allah, he makes dua, his dua is accepted. إِمَّا أَن يُعَدْلَ لَهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِمَّا أَن يُدَخِّرَ لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ وَإِمَّا أَن يَسْرِفَ عَنْهُ مِنَ السُّوءِ مِثْلِهَا. Either Allah would grant him the same he had asked for in this dunya, or may Allah maybe preserve this dua for the akhirah. May Allah may give him the better in akhirah. Or because of his dua, it could be more likely that Allah would save him from any calamity, any hardship that he was facing. But Allah knew, Allah would save him. So dua are never rejected, my dear. Allah loves us. Allah wants us to make more and more dua, just as we offer nawafil, just as we fast, just as we perform hajj and umrah, we donate. All these are different kinds of ibadah. Dua is also a kind of ibadah. Our beloved Prophet ﷺ is saying that لَيْسَ شَيْءٌ أَكْرَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنَ الدُّعَى. There's nothing dearer in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except more than dua. The more you make dua, the more Allah loves you. The more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gets happy with you, he's pleased with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, قُلْ مَا يَعْبَأُ بِكُمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاءُكُمْ. That if you do not make dua, Allah would not care for you. Allah would not care for you. If you make more dua, he would get more happy with you. Because لَيْسَ شَيْءٌ أَكْرَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنَ الدُّعَى. That's why, if you read the books of Ahadith, you will be amazed. There are, for every aspect and movement of our life, there are dua. When you go to enter your home, there is a dua. When you leave your home, your dua. When you start writing, you know, there is a dua. When you go to bathroom, like out of bathroom, you go to bed, you wake up, in morning, evening, all the time there are du'as. It means that a Muslim, he must call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. This is not that we should make dua and then stop waiting for its result. This dua must be a part of our life. Just as we talk to people, we must communicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. Keep asking, keep asking. And ask Allah with yaqeen. Our beloved Prophet is saying that udu'u Allah wa antum muqinuna bil ijaba. Call on Allah subhanallah with full certainty and yaqeen that surely your dua would be accepted. If you have this yaqeen, surely Allah would accept your dua. Because Allah subhanahu he says, this hadith Qudsi, ana 'inda wanni 'abdi bi. I am as my slave thinks of me. If you think that Allah accept your dua, surely he would accept your dua. Have this yaqeen. Udu'u Allah wa antum muqinuna bil ijaba. And if you read Quran, if you read the books of Ahadith, you will be amazed. There are hundreds of example incidents that whatever someone, some prophet or any sahabi, he made dua, the same thing he got in this dunya. Look at the dua. Once our beloved Prophet ﷺ, he was delivering khutbah, and during khutbah, a man entered in the masjid. Ya Rasulullah ﷺ, halakat al-amwal wa fata'at al-subul. Oh Allah, the Senior, because of drought, because of the lack of rain, all things are destroyed, our cattle, our field, everything destroyed, make dua. So during khutbah, our beloved Prophet ﷺ made dua. Allahumma, oh Allah, we want rain. Oh Allah, grant us, bless us with rain during khutbah. And the Sahaba, Rasulullah, when he said that, when we entered the masjid, the sun was shining. But when we left the masjid after khutbah, there was so heavy rain, it was very hard for us to get to our home. The, within minutes, Allah accepted the dua. Look at the dua of Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala, he was in a dilemma. Because he loved our beloved Prophet, he loved his company, and also he loved his mother. His mother was not Muslima. She hated our beloved Prophet. She used to talk badly about our beloved Prophet. But Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala, he still used to serve her. This is our deen. If parents, they are not Muslims, still we have to serve them. Still we have to be obedient. But if they are mu'min, look at our generation, my dear brother. Mostly we don't care about our parents. So Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala's mother was not Muslima, but still he was serving her, and she used to talk badly about our beloved Prophet. Once he was giving her da'wah, spreading message, and she said some bad word about our beloved Prophet. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala, he started crying because he loved our beloved and he loved mother as well. So he came to our beloved Prophet, make dua for my mother, may Allah guide her toward Islam. So our beloved Prophet, he said, Allahumma hdi umma Abu Huraira. Oh Allah, guide the mother of Abu Huraira toward Islam. Allah, give her hidayah. So Abu Huraira radiallahu, he had so yakin about this dua, he left the masjid straightway to see the acceptance of this dua. So few minutes before, she was cursing our Prophet. So now when he went to his home, so he saw that door was locked and his mother was taking bath, shower. So she said, Ala rislika Abu Huraira, Abu Huraira, stop, where are you up? So he stood outside the home. So after some minutes, she finished her bath and she wore proper dress and she said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. So Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala, he again left the house. Again he was crying, now out of joy, out of happiness. And he said, Oh Allah, the Messenger of Allah, Allah had accepted your dua. Oh Allah, is going to make dua that may Allah make me and my mother dearer to the believers. Believer, they should love me and my mother. So our beloved Prophet ﷺ again made dua. Allahumma ja'al ubayda kahada ya'ni Aba Huraira wa ummahu ahabba ila ibadika al-mu'mineen wa habbib al-mu'mineen ilayhim. Oh Allah, make Abu Huraira and his mother beloved to the believers. And make believers dearer to them. And Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala say that, afterward, whoever listened about me, he loved me. All of us love Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala. All the time you hear his name in ahadith, in khutbah, in speeches, in bayan, in lecture. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala. An Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala. An Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala. So my dear brother, the point is that dua, this is the month of dua. We all have issues. We all have so many problems in respect of our business. All other family issues, issues from your children, your spouse, so many issues in your body, disease. Oh, make dua, your dua surely will be accepted, and you make this dua with yakin that surely Allah will accept that. And the more you make dua, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love you. May Allah grant us husnul khatimah, especially in this month, the best dua, may Allah grant us husnul khatimah. May Allah cause us die on Islam. Tawaffani muslima. That was the dua of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, who was given the kingdom in this dunya. What he made dua at that time, tawaffani, Allah, you have given everything in this dunya. No, Allah, cause me die on Islam. This is the best dua. If you are given husnul khatima, as we know the hadith of the Prophet, he said that Man qala la ilaha illallah, who said la ilaha illallah at the last moment of his life, dakhal al-jannah, surely he would get jannah. May Allah grant us the khatimah, may Allah accept our ibadah, may Allah accept our fast, our qiyam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us Husnul Khatimah, may Allah free our necks from the fire of hell. May Allah save us from all trouble in this dunya and the trouble of akhirah. May Allah grant our deceived people Jannah. May Allah save us from all trouble. Inna alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi wa ba'ad. Mera khayal hai aksar bhai urdu samajhte hain. چند الفاظ میں اردو کرنا بھی پسند کروں گا کہ جس طرح کہ ہم نے بیان کیا کہ یہ مہینہ صرف روزوں کا مہینہ نہیں ہے، یہ صرف قیام کا مہینہ نہیں ہے، تراوی کا مہینہ نہیں ہے، اعتکاف کا مہینہ نہیں، چیریٹی صدقہ زکات کا مہینہ نہیں، یہ مہینہ عبادت کے ساتھ ساتھ دعا کا مہینہ بھی ہے. اس مہینے میں دعا یقیناً قبول فرماتے ہیں. صحیح حدیث ہے، آپ نے فرمایا لکل مسلم دعوت مستجابہ یدعو بها فی رمضان. مسلمان جو بھی ماہ رمضان میں دعا کرتا ہے اللہ اس کی دعا قبول فرماتا ہے. یہ اللہ کی صفت ہے، یہ اللہ کی خوبی ہے، یہ اللہ کا وصف ہے، یہ اللہ کا اسم ہے. اس میں اسماء الحسنی میں سے ہے کہ اللہ المجیب ہے، مجیب. اللہ ہماری دعائیں سنتا ہے، اللہ دعائیں قبول کرتا ہے، اللہ دعائیں سننا، دعائیں قبول کرنا پسند کرتا ہے. لیس شیئن اکرم علی اللہ من الدعاء، دعا سے بڑھ کر اللہ کو کوئی اور چیز محبوب نہیں. جتنی زیادہ آپ دعا کریں گے اتنے آپ اللہ کے مقرب اور محبوب بنیں گے. اس لیے ہمارے نبی علیہ السلام ہر لمحہ ان کی زبان، یہ دعا یہ عبادت ہے، ہر لمحہ آپ زبان اللہ کے ساتھ منسلک رہے، آپ اللہ سے گفتگو کرتے رہیں، کمیونیکیٹ کرتے رہیں، سنتوشنا کرتے رہیں. یہ نبیوں کے اوصاف تھے اور یہ دعا ڈیفینیٹلی آپ کو فائدہ دیتی ہے. یا تو وہی چیز ملتے ہوئے اگر اللہ پسند کریں گے، اللہ اس سے بہتر آپ کو آخر میں دے رہے ہیں، دعا ضائع نہیں جاتی. اور این ممکن ہے کہ کوئی آنے والی مصیبت ہی آپ اس دعا کرنے سے اللہ نے واقعی مصیبت ڈالی. تو اللہ رب العالمین نے نبیوں کے واقعے اس لیے بیان فرمائے ہیں ہمیں یقین دلانے کے لیے. کتنی بڑی مصیبت میں تھے یونس علیہ السلام، سوچئے. اللہ کہتے ہیں ونادى في الظلمات، اندھیروں میں اس نے پکارا، پکارا تو کس کو؟ اللہ الہ الا انت سبحانك، اللہ تیرے علاوہ کوئی نہیں ہے، اللہ تو پاک ہے. انی کنت من الظالمین. اللہ کہتے ہیں فاستجبنا بنانا ونجیناه من الغم وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين، ہم نے اس کی دعا سن لی، اسے غم سے نجات دے دی اور اسی طرح مومنوں کو نجات دے دی. آپ نے کہ جو کلمہ یونس اسلام نے کہا تھا لا الہ الا انت سبحانک، جو بھی یہ پڑھ کر دعا کرے گا اللہ اس کی دعا لازمی قبول فرمائے گا. اس کو اپنی دعاؤں کا حصہ بنائیں گے، لا الہ الا انت سبحانک انی کنت من الظالمین. جو بھی اس کے بعد اب اللہ سے دعا کریں گے اللہ یقینی آپ کی دعا قبول فرمائے گا، کیونکہ اللہ نے یونس اسلام کی دعا قبول فرمائی ہے. اس کے ساتھ میرے بھائیوں یہ یقین ہو کہ اللہ میری دعائیں سنتا ہے، اور پھر اپنی دعا کی قبولیت کے لیے سب سے بڑا جو طریقہ ہے کہ آپ دوسروں کے حق میں دعا کیجیے. جو دوسرے ہیں اپنے ساتھ ساتھ، جو دوسرے مسلمان آپ کے بہن بھائی، رشتہ دار، پڑوسی، جو بھی آپ جس کے فوت شدہ ہو چکے ہیں، کثرت سے ان کے حق میں دعا کریں. حدیث شریف میں آتا ہے جب کوئی مسلمان کسی دوسرے کے حق میں دعا کرتا ہے تو فرشتہ دعا کرتا ہے آمین ولک بمثل، اللہ تیری دعا قبول کرے اور جو تو نے مانگا اللہ تجھے بھی وہ عطا فرمائے. تو جب آپ دوسرے کے حق میں دعا کرتے ہیں، آپ اپنے کون دعا کرتا ہے؟ فرشتہ دعا کرتا ہے. اور فرشتے کس نے مقرر کیے؟ اللہ نے مقرر کیے ہماری دعا کرنے کے لیے. جب اللہ خود فرشتہ مقرر کرتا ہے تو وہ دعا کیسے رد ہو سکتی ہے میرے بھائیوں؟ اللہ تعالیٰ ہمیں صحیح معنوں میں مسلمان بننے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے. اللہ ہمارے روزے قبول فرمائے، جو ہم سے قومیاں گزاری ہوں گے اللہ معاف فرمائے. اللہ ہمارے جتنے فوج شدگان ہیں، ہمارے شدار، والدین، عائضہ، کر اللہ سب کی مغفرت فرمائے. جو بیمار ہیں اللہ شفا قابل عطا فرمائے. اللہ ہم سب کی نیکیاں قبول فرمائے، گناہ ہم سارے معاف فرمائے. اللہ جہنم کی آگ سے عذاب فرمائے. اللہ انك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم زينا بزينة الإيمان وجعلنا هداة مهتدين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.